Sophia Nelson, former House GOP investigative counsel and adjunct professor at Christopher Newport University and a senior columnist at The Daily Beast. Thanks so much for being with us. The president briefly mentioned Kenosha, but only in the context of it being one of several, what he said, called Democrat-run cities under mob rule. What's the message you think he's sending by doing this?
You know, Anderson, if you watch both the conventions over the last 2 weeks, you walk away understanding that we are living in two very different Americas. The president's speech last night, I have no problem with politics. You can talk to your base. You can talk about what your party believes in. But I have a big problem with a sitting president who's sitting on his watch and has this type of racial and civil unrest, not mentioning the young man's name. Say his name, Jacob Blake. Talk about it. If you want to talk about law and order, fine. We all believe in law and order, but what about the causes of why the people are protesting? What about the vigilante who shot protesters who were unarmed? That young man's life now is ruined. He's murdered some people. So he made a bad choice on his Facebook page or whatever has incited to him to this violence. For the president not to address that is negligence and it's malfeasance, and it's dividing our country deeply.
It's interesting because on the one hand, the message coming from the White House this last week has been there's chaos in American cities, there's lawlessness, and only the president can make it right. Only the president can bring law and order, when in fact he is overseeing right now this very what he describes as chaos and lawlessness. So he's trying to have it both ways. On the one hand, he's saying this is all happening and I'm needed in order to set it right, when in fact he is in a position of power. And if he has some magic solution for setting it right, he could do that now.
You know, Anderson, that's exactly right. It's a little bit silly, right, for me to tell you I wrecked something or I caused something, but I'm the person that should fix what I broke. I don't think that works. And I think that in this context, a better message for him is I'm going to bring the country together. We've seen unrest. We've seen civil disturbance since Charlottesville in 2017. That's when this all started with the both sides thing. So this president has dropped the ball on this divide in America. He has embraced the Confederate flag. He has embraced the Confederacy. He has embraced traitors to their country and said that they are the people he will defend. These are dead people for 150 years, statues, and that's where he comes down. So he was just wrong not to mention what's happening on our streets and why. He can talk about law and order. He can support the police. We all support the police. But we also support freedom of speech in this country. We also support the right to protest. For him to say that he's the only guy that can fix what he broke is stupid. It's just silly.
Sophia Nelson, I appreciate your time. Thank you.
Thanks, Anderson.